In this video, we're looking at a common mistake that happens when solving Atwood machines. So in the problem, we're given this simple Atwood machine where a 2 kilogram cart is being pulled along a horizontal track. That's tied to a 1 kilogram hanging mass. And then what we're asked for is just the acceleration of the Atwood machine. And what we're looking at here is a very common incorrect solution to the problem. So what the student did here is start by saying the force of gravity down on the 1 kilogram mass must be mg. They plug in the numbers and they find out it's 9.8 newtons. Next, they say, well, the tension must be 9.8 newtons pulling up on this mass. And that's actually the conceptual error right there. But just to follow things through, they then say the tension is 9.8 newtons on the other end of the string. And then they apply Newton's second law to the cart, F net equals ma. They plug in the force of 9.8 newtons and solve for the acceleration, and they get 4.9 meters per second squared. Now, this turns out to be the wrong answer because there was a concept error made right here where we said the tension was equal to mg on this 1 kilogram mass. If the tension was equal to mg here, the forces would balance on that mass and there would be no acceleration. So let's just start this thing over and we'll fix that problem and see how the problem unfolds. So certainly there's nothing wrong with starting out by finding the force of gravity downward on that 1 kilogram mass. And that was done correctly in the student work. But again, we know the tension must be less than mg, otherwise this thing wouldn't be accelerating. So we have to leave the tension as an unknown here. It will be the same on both ends of the string, but it's unknown. So what we do is apply Newton's second law to each moving piece of the system now. I'm just going to start with the 2 kilogram mass. And we apply F net equals ma to this guy. And we only have one force pulling horizontally. That's the tension pulling to the right. And that'll be equal to the mass, which is 2 kilograms, multiplied by the acceleration. We do a similar thing for the 1 kilogram mass. And we're going to call downward positive for that piece of the system, because we want A to stand for a positive acceleration on both of these objects. And so we call the 9.8 newtons pointing downward, we call that positive. And the T pointing up, we call negative. So there's the net force on the 1 kilogram mass, and that's equal to the mass itself, which is just 1, multiplied by the acceleration. This gives us a system of 2 equations and 2 unknowns, where the tension and the acceleration are the unknowns. And this is set up really nice for elimination. I just add the left sides of the equations and I get 9.8. T's are canceling out there, T and negative T. And then on the right side, I get 3A. And now we divide by 3. And we find that A is 3.27 meters per second squared. And that's it.
If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.